magnetic volumes are very popular and well-known notion in convex geometry, where they are studied in the class of convex compact sets. In particular, they were defined, and they were defined yesterday in Schneider's talk with some applications to stochastic geometry. Today I will redefine them and, again in slightly different situation. In Riemannian geometry, they are somehow known under the name of Lipschitz-Kirin curvatures. However, my impression is that they are not very well known to experts in Riemannian geometry, except of three particular cases. My interest in this project came from my interest for many years for evaluations on convex sets, and then some subsequent project of generalizations of parts of evaluation theory to manifolds. And however, this part will not be explicit in this talk. I'm not an expert in Riemannian geometry and Alexandrov geometry. A person by whom I was advised all the time on this subject is Anton Petrunin. He should be a co-author of this conjecture, but he thinks different. As I said, notion of intrinsic volumes of convex bodies goes back at least to Steiner in low dimensions. Certainly it was known to Minkowski in arbitrary dimensions. It was studied quite extensively in convex geometry. For example, one knows Alexandrov, Alexander Templin inequalities for it. Then in 1939, suggested an extension of this notion to closed manifolds. Later, it was generalized to some more general spaces, this boundary. The definition, while the definition of the center of Posner's talk, I will remind it, it is based on some non-trivial result of him. Let me remind you of Weyl's construction or definition. So let M be a closed, smooth Riemannian manifold. Consider an isometric embedding iota from this to a high dimensional union space. Such an isometric embedding is known to exist. It is highly non-unique, for example, by Nash theorem, although Weyl used weaker result available at the time about existence of isometric embeddings, local existence of local isometric embeddings. Okay, no matter. And consider now volume inside this Euclidean space of epsilon neighborhood of the image of this manifold, epsilon u. And the first observation of Weyl was that if epsilon is very small and non-negative, then this volume is polynomial in epsilon of the following form, epsilon to power and get comma minus little m, sum I from 0 to little m, dimension of our manifold, epsilon to the power n minus I, di of m, and some standard normalization, which I will not write down in kappa, which depends on I, m, and k. So far, it is an easy statement, And a priori, these coefficients, Vi, they may depend, they do depend on the manifold, of course, on Riemannian metric measure, but the non-trivial theorem of Weyl is they don't depend on the embedding. They are normalized correct.
What is this?
More precisely, he showed that these quantities are integrals over the manifold of some polynomial of Riemann curvature tensor. Examples, special cases of such, and they are called intrinsic quantities. This is I's intrinsic volume of M G. Examples, if I is equal to N, Vn, it is just Riemannian volume. If I is equal to zero, V0 is a characteristic. And the corresponding formula of given by Weyl is generalized Gauss-Bonnet formula. I forgot, I also should mention that since manifold is assumed to be closed, half of these coefficients vanish. Every second vanish. For odd dimension manifolds, it means, this equality means that where the characteristic vanishes. It is for small epsilon. And okay, half of them vanish, and Vn minus 2. Is proportional up to some standard normalization integral of this kind of curvature of the manifold. And these are three cases which are well familiar to Riemannian geometers.
But there are more intrinsic volumes. If one restricts these intrinsic volumes to complex sets, actually one can do this construction in the same way for manifolds with boundaries, so you can restrict them to complex domains in Euclidean space. So
Vi restricted to convex compact sets. It is very classical thing, are continuous in Gauss domain. On these domains, and extend the continuity to all convex compact sets. Convex compact sets, with smooth boundary, right? I define only with smooth boundary. And extend by continuity to all convex So, sorry, this boundary now?
Yeah.
Will are surface Euclidean space. Let me repeat more slowly what I said. We can consider intrinsic volumes on convex domains in fixed Euclidean space. There are special classes of manifolds, also this boundary, but this boundary comes down. There is a following important property. So, this restriction of intrinsic volumes to convex domains extends by continuity in the Hausdorff metric to all convex contour sets, not necessarily with smooth boundary. Any regularity.
Do you need quite smooth for curvature?
For this construction, I used C infinity regularity, but probably can be reduced. But for to write down Weyl's formulas, which I did not write, one needs at least C2 regularity. But in fact, it extends to one needs less regularity if one works with convex domains. And actually, the starting point of my work was an attempt to understand this property, but in case of manifolds. Because in Weyl's picture, because this property disappeared, and how when I work evaluation in convex sets, this property is used all the time and proved to be useful. So I tried to recover this property in a different setup. For example, okay, so in Riemannian geometry, there are several notions and conversions of manifolds. And in principle, one could try various types of convergence to check continuity in some form of intrinsic volume. But I will discuss Gromov-Hausdorff convergence, which seems to work well, at least on conjectural level. And nevertheless, there are some special results known which can be considered of special cases of these conjectures I will present. And they work for this kind of convergence. Let me remind you briefly the definition of Gromov-Hausdorff distance. So between two compact metric spaces. So this distance is interval of Hausdorff distance between x and y, where interval is taken over all metrics. Y are isometric, so it is a real, actual non-degenerate metric on isometric classes of compact metric spaces. And so now let me introduce a notation. So fix natural number n, real number here, positive number b, and real number kappa, and define m, n, g, kappa, the set of isometric classes this diameter most G and sectional curvature at least alpha. Schools are closed. V equivalent is a drawn contour distance, and the theorem, drawn compactness theorem says that this space includes this drawn contour distance is pre-compact. Which means the abstract completion of this as an abstract metric space is compact. So we have the following situation. And on this space, we have condensed volumes. The first question which might be asked, whether condensed volumes extend by continuity to this completion. The answer is no, and there are very easy counterexamples. Nevertheless,
this completion corresponds to
It responds to development metric and topological singularities. If you ask, I plan to say something, but the question is right. Not, I will answer this now. The point of this completion, which is can be interpreted as some compact metric spaces, not necessarily smooth manifolds. And as far as I understand, by now there is no complete characterization of these metric spaces. Nevertheless, there are many known properties of these spaces. Some of them are accepted as some basic properties of them are accepted as a conventional list of axioms of what is called Alexander space. I will not write down these axioms because some technical. So every point of this space is a compact Alexander space, but the converse is not known, so there is no complete description of metric spaces here. This definition and theory of such Alexander spaces in two dimensions. It was in the 40s with Alexandrov in modern multi-dimensional Gaussian and the Burago-Brown and Feldman in 1990. And since I don't have time to define this notion, what is important to know about Alexandrov space is that they are stable under Gromov-Hausdorff convergence if curvature is bounded below the uniformity. And some basic examples, namely convex compact sets in the Euclidean space or sphere or hyperbolic space are Alexandrov spaces and the boundaries also.
And the
boundaries.
What?
Boundaries.
Okay.
Convex hypersurfaces. And this is a compact space. So, as I said, here we have functions, intrinsic volumes. They don't extend by continuity here. And I would like to suggest a new conjectural space of geometric origin to which intrinsic volumes do extend. I'm going to invert this space of smooth Riemannian manifolds with these bounds to some other topological space.
I want. And check this result, you said. And check the view. Final polygon. Final factor. Final polygon. But all to the left. Yes. We don't know to, know how to define points for this space. We don't know how to define topology on it. However, we do know how to define convergent sequences in this space. Modulus some unpublished result of one. So let me describe points of this space. Points of this space are pairs. Alexandrov space is from here. And the other is function in this space up to the action of the group of isomers. So the function is constructible. Integer value function constructible with respect to the one component configuration.
So it is time for the following or not? What is the difference between the response of the video F, or divided by the final group? Do you just start with that?
Yes, no.
It's not possible.
Group is fixed for you.
I don't understand that. The take of the manifold polytherms divided by group is fixed for you. Take a question. If this structure is constructed, then for that.
The points of the space is your object orbital, yeah, and various constructible functions. How do you reconstruct from the
I'm asking for this is orbital. Orbital good for you? Is possible by five by five. Are they good for you?
Yes.
You don't have to
go. There are examples of the Alexander space.
Yeah, no, but are they already in your space that you don't have to leave? If your formulas are divine formulas of life. Okay. This example, you want to regularize something to left, right?
Regularize singularity is not of Alexander's, but space of Alexander's space.
Okay.
This is the kind of normalization of this space.
Mm-hmm. There are many similarities, right? This ambiguity in the construction. Because the whole definition of the space is there because it has the orbital. And so you are getting the right to take what they call the step there.
Roman discussed with Joseph Bushkent, he said that all the spaces should be not spaces but steps. This is not what you said.
Okay. whether this is stack or whether this is
a I'm going to look at a different direction. Okay. And previous people, what you say, different question of interpretation. Music volumes will be continuous from this space, yeah, judgment. Yeah. Which is not for the Alexander space or your own people in particular, but it's something that will happen.
What is this matrix?
We have constructible function with respect to some canonical stratification, which I don't have time to explain. On each compact Alexander space has canonical finite stratification. This is Riemann equilibrium. What is important to know is that it behaves, it is finite and behaves well under the algebra field. Also, there should be some bound on this function. And brackets means that you consider this function up to actual isometry group of.
Well, of course, we have an actual vector exactly your way to the order of this fixture. So exactly what I'm saying. You have action fixture, you have this order of this fixture, and you have now the formula. So I believe that the way the formula becomes true is to increase the volume in this way, it's going to the order of the group.
Madam, how would you think volume is related to this camera?
I will
explain. So the brief answer. So I explained this space. If you put bound, some bound on the function also, in order to then we can introduce the notion of convergent sequence here. Unfortunately, not yet factor measure. But presumably, there is topology which induces this convergent. And then the conjecture is the relation to intrinsic volumes that all of them are extend by continuity from here to here. By the way, this map is now the non-trivial thing is to define convergence in this space. For the sake of simplicity, I will consider sequence of smooth manifolds which converges to some object here. So let us assume for the moment that it converges to some Alexander space. But now I can lift this sequence to here, just as M by M constant function. What would be the limit in this space after choice of subsequence? Now comes general construction with some, and this construction works with on publicly without a phantom. The general construction is may sound familiar to some of you, it's kind of generalized of version of neural construction of nearby sites of ancient type. So here we have the example space needs. Here we have most manifold M I. After a choice of subsequence, the following is possible. So we are going to produce constructible function on the image. We fix an arbitrary point in the image space and consider a ball for the union of these two spaces centered at this point. Of fragments epsilon, where epsilon is very small. We consider I very large. And consider this part, this intersection. Consider the characteristic of this show that if epsilon is very small and pi is very large, this does not depend on pi for large i. This sequence of integer numbers stabilizes. This way of characteristics stabilizes. And moreover, this linear does not depend on small epsilon. This gives you an integer one function on the limiting space x after you choose a subsequent. However, the construction involves some choice.
In particular, the right neighborhood, which has stability, you do not evolve. It will be just the standard experimental construction. It's the same, yeah. But this construction, when this annoying neighborhood is stable to avoid it. This experimental construction is somewhat different from that. It's not evolved. But complement from any bottom object. You are sure it's a ball, but not
No, well, I will simplify. I think it is what you take in your paper, you consider ball, the homology of ball, method to the homology of ball of five times smaller radius.
There is Telemann construction that is smarter than that.
Is not bounded from the law, it does work in this classical situation for me, you know, the law, you know, for the basic points. It doesn't. Maybe it works for some other kinds of problems. Okay, so this function is defined actually due to some definition of Gromov Pavlov matrix. It is defined uniquely only up to actually the group of isometries, and another important property that it is constant on the strata of Kalman-Petrova section. It is constructible. And there is a bound on this function, it follows, I think, from your paper about Bayesian number, Hermitian Bayesian numbers, small balls, or functional balls. Okay. Well, so, but this is notion of convergent sequence. We don't know how to use it by topology. And the conjecture is, let me repeat right now explicitly. Before I go So this space should be compact because this bound of contracted functions, which I mentioned from Gromov's result. And if continuous function, we have continuous function on compact space, the difference should be bound. And hence, we have the following conceptual corollary that there is a constant dependent on N, E, and kappa, such that all intrinsic volumes are bounded by this constant for any manifold. Smoothly Riemannian manifold, of diameter at most D, and curvature, and sectional curvature is kappa. In this case, there are, for this conjecture, it's still open this generality, but it is known to be true in three cases. And in these three cases, I'm going to state it, and they are non-trivial. I is equal to n. We have volume. So we know it is just volume. This is called Bishop inequality. That's the result. Second case, I is equal to 0. This is Euler characteristic. This is also bounded and it follows from a stronger result of Gromov about estimate of Betti numbers. It shows that even Betti numbers of them have to be bounded. And the last case, which is known, integral of scalar curvature. And this was shown by the problem in 2000. All other intrinsic volumes is integral.
So if the volume is bounded, then you have only lower bounds on the sectional curvature.
Yes.
Okay. So that's why it's not, 3 doesn't follow from 1 trivial.
Oh, no, not at all.
Kappa is not positive. Kappa is just a real number.
Yes, it might be a
and F, it is not bounded from above.
What? F?
Yes.
Which F?
F on the...
The constructible function, it is bounded on both sides.
On both sides.
It has to be bounded on both sides. I did not explain yet. This bound is non-trivial. It is bound
on this function. It is bounded on both sides, and it follows from the Gromov's theorem, which I did not formulate explicitly.
Okay.
If the limit is continuous,
yeah,
I can say that.
This is true, yeah?
This is not known to be true, even if there is no collapse.
Uh-huh.
In general, for volume, it is true, and it's for Riemann. For volume characteristic, it is a Riemann stability theorem. And for integral allow a little bit of general conjecture, and it will add a little bit more explicit. So, let us again in the situation when the sequence is a sequence of smooth manifolds. So let's assume that we have a sequence of smooth manifolds which converges to a pair in some respect and constructible function. In this situation, there should be, I will choose another index, there should be a limit of, well, if the constructible function is well defined, there should be limit. Linear of implicit modules and now I would like to say to what it is equal. Every constructed, so at some respect we need to have the joint union of the Riemann and Riemann strata.
Can you remind, what is the most important?
They introduced the notion of extreme and they proved one real result of finding the many results. So that was the intersect.
Okay,
does
what
the intersect
of the
problem?
I don't know, I don't know. But here we have
step, you know, such kind of domain rules.
This is because you know of convex sets. Convex sets
are not very linear.
Because the identification is still, you know, the political.
No, it is not trivial for the computer, but
but
constructible functions are always one.
You mentioned that in the beginning that the result of this contractual function is easy to see that the I can grow up or something. How could you explain this before?
Why we need this space M for top? It is very unique. You can take sphere, two-dimensional sphere of radius, small radius of epsilon, it collapses to point. Its earlier characteristic is 2, but its earlier characteristic is 1. That also, you can take flat torus of arbitrary small diameter, its earlier characteristic is 0, it collapses to point, its earlier characteristic is 1. So you have two different meanings.
So you have to add this vanishing side.
Yes. Maybe I will show you one more result, which is rather elementary, the only result of this talk, just to show what happens in the whole situation. Assume we have Riemannian submersion of two compact matrices, Riemannian submersion. Other things for them, then one is possible to
Of course. Whenever better numbers to divide, they have to divide.
Together more or less, it's in that direction. We go down the university and then it's a little bit to the left. It's called Targ. Maybe I'll just write it here.
We're going to the direction of C.
Auditorium, you can Google it and it will show you where to walk if you have Google Maps. And if not, you just walk with all of us. There is a reception and then a concert. Okay, so, and yes, there is, the reception is there.